Hello and welcome, my friend. And then I am planning to tell you that how to add more engine and motor oil to Toyota Prius hybrid car. And also how we can inspect oil level in Toyota Prius car in monthly basis. Okay, and now everything is ready in here. And then we go to look that area, because there is this oil dip stick. Okay, and firstly, it is easy in this Toyota and Lexus cars to find this dipstick, because it is yellow, this dipstick, and there is even in Toyota way, there is text in here, that engine oil in here, look. And this is quality, there is engine oil in here, and this is our dipstick, what we are next measuring and using. And this measurement really happens so that firstly I have to notice that there is this dipstick, and then I pull out that in this way, and I have to handle this like in horizontally this way, not in this way, because now we are looking oil in that area. And next I need clean cotton cloth. Okay, and then we need really clean white cotton cloth. And if you like to purchase that kind of cotton cloth, please go to visit in IKEA made in Sweden warehouses in USA. And there is a lot of cotton cloth what we can purchase for engine these repairs in IKEA stores in USA. Okay, and now when I have clean cotton cloth and I have cut and made small particles in this my cotton cloth, I take my dipstick, and in this area I have to clean that. In this area I take fingers in here, and then I pull out totally. And this job's purpose is to clean both sides very carefully in that way. And then I install this my cotton cloth in clean position in engine area. Okay, and then we can look a little bit closer this dipstick. Okay. And this dipstick, this is like handle position. There is small rubber gasket. And then this area is steel. And now when I move that in here, in that area we have these measurement levels in here. And the trick is that there are two dots, small and big. And let's go to look closer, and there is small propeller blade in here. And this down level, that area is low amount, and this is this full level, like full oil level. And oil must to be always in here. And let's go to look even closer. Okay, and now I have installed this my dipstick in table, and when I move that in this area is this handle, but the most critical area is this area in here. And now I use my pencil, and this is this area what must to be always in clean. And there is really two dots. First one is in here, that one. This one in here, and now I do in here also small markings in here. Now we can see closer, there's third dot. This is like low level. This is really bad thing if our oil is in like in this area. And normally oil is in that area in here, and oil level is in here in our engine. This is really critical thing. Because if we have oil like in low amount, that means that now we have some oil leak, or our engine eats and consumes oil. Like we have those bad piston rings and two small piston. And if our oil level is always in here, we have issue, because normally oil must be in this level in here. And this is like in here full line. full. And oil must be always in here. It is like 100% full. And this amount is in here. It is 1 liter. 1 liter is this gap in here to here. This is 1 liter or 1/4. Quarter is this amount. And always oil level must be in here, in this up area. And in sometimes even I can keep my oil level in 1 centimeter little bit up in here, because more oil is better for my engine. Because if we have more oil, like in my case, this is like Peter's level in here. And Peter keeps like 100%, 110% level. And there is almost 2 deciliters more oil in my engine. And why I keep my engine level normally in here? The reason is that when we have more oil, then our oil temperature is lower. It is a little bit, maybe 1 Fahrenheit or 1 Celsius lower. And if we have low and more cooler oil in our engine lasts longer. And this is the point. And always, if I have 100%, 110% this oil level, it can go down when engine is running little by little. But normally, the level must be always in this full line. And there is the small markings, this like full markings dot in here. And now we check that we have really oil in this amount. And if we don't, then we have to add in here more oil. And let's go to look that what is my car's oil level. And we go to engine area next. Okay, and then really, when we have clean this our oil dipstick in that way, now I clean again that there is no any markings. There are only those dots. Now I need to install this my dipstick in this whole pack. And let's go to look that how it is good to install in right way in there. And there is really hole in here, that hole, and in this hole I install carefully this my dipstick, and next I need to press that totally down so much that we can hear this click. Now listen this click. When we heard and we can hear this click, then we can think that now this my oil dipstick is in this measurement position. And now I can take this carefully out, and this way, and this step is careful way in that way. And now we have in here this measurement amount in here. And we can look that how much I have oil. Okay, and now it is important that I keep this my dipstick in this horizontally position in this way. And then we can look this amounts, and my oil is very good because it is like yellow. This is, we can see that if we have totally black, then our gasoline engine is consuming gasoline or oil is old. Okay, and now when we look at my level, this is this low level dot in here, and that one is in full. And now it seems that my level is full. Everything is okay, because oil level is in here even a little bit more. And if we have that kind of situation, everything is fine. And it is good to sometimes to clean that again. Now I install this in vertically in here. And now we measure this oil level again. And I install my cotton cloth in here. And let's do that again. The sound, and now I pull that up carefully. Now we look at what is my oil level.
Okay, my oil level is just 110% full. There is this line. It is just in here. Okay, excellent, fine. And I can rotate that in another direction. And there is also these symbols. And if we measure this our oil level in every month, it is then we can guarantee that my engine lasts longer, because oil is most important thing in our engine. And especially that there is more oil than less oil. Remember that if your oil level is in like this low level amount, then I can guarantee that this your engine lasts lower miles in use. And that's check every month that your Toyotas and Lexus engines oil level is in this up position, and even in this mile level 110% line, like a little bit higher. Okay, that kind of information to you, my friend. Okay, and how I can add engine oil to Toyota Prius car? How this happens? Okay, and first step when we are adding engine oil is that we have to find this oil cap hat. And in Toyota and Lexus cars, this is easy because we need to find only black cap hat. And in this my car, there is this engine oil cap hat, this one. And next I need to open this cap hat. Okay, and normally these cap hats, they open in this direction, like anti-clockwise, and these are tied to open, and that's we need pliers. Okay, we need really pliers, like in this one, and when I install that in here, I carefully move that in this direction. Now I compress, and now this engine cap hat opens. And there is engine oil mark in here, and then install this in up face in clean place. That it don't be carefully that you don't drop this cap in ground. Okay, and next step is that we have this clean cotton cloth, because normally oil drops in these side areas, and this is like protective thing, because soon we add in here this engine oil, and we have to clean and dry this oil drops away in engine area, because there is risk of fire if we spill and spray oil, engine oil, to like exhaust manifold. Okay, and then we need three or two things. Firstly, we need good quality engine oil, and Mobil 1 is excellent engine oil. Almost all engines, and like this 5W50 is good, or 0W230 is good. But Mobil 1 is excellent oil, and in now in these cases, this amount what we add in there is normally half quarters or half liters. And after that, we measure this oil level in this our oil dipstick. And we can use also this funnel, and then this oil goes much more inside in this hole, if we use funnel, and then this measurement cup is good. And now I do so that I add in here, there is 500 milliliters, is like about 0.5 liters or 0.55 quarters. And now I add in here firstly, this is my engine oil, a little bit compression, oil comes faster. Okay, and now there is 500, and engine oil is there, and then I only carefully I drain in this oil in inside that hole, and do not insert too much this oil because it can spill and drain out in this hole. Carefully wait a couple of seconds. Okay, good. And now I have really add in here in there like 5/4 or 5 liters this engine oil, and then we go to check this engine oil amount, and we can add smaller amounts in there, and our target is this oil dipsticks high level, this top level. This is the target level. And if oil goes a little bit upper in this oil level, we can drain out engine oil a little bit. But it is not so accurate if there is like 1 dl too much oil in our engine. There is no any issues if we have more oil. Okay, and then when I install this my oil cap hat back, firstly I clean these areas that there is no any oil in there, and then I install this my oil cap hat, and I rotate that in this way, and then in this fastening process we can use a little bit these pliers, but be carefully that only a couple of millimeters, very short amount, because this is plastic cap hat and plastic is weak. Actually our fingers is enough, because if we tight this plastic cap hat too much it can go broken, and then we have to go to visit in Toyota dealership center, and they will sell to us new oil cap hat. Okay, but I have not ever broke any Toyota's or Lexus oil cap hat, but in Ford cap hat I have broke one of in Ford cars cap hat. Okay.